Well, good morning and welcome to the life of Nathan Harris. All right, let's get going. I got this dirty desk going on here. Here's a little idea of what's going on. It's so dirty. I got a bit of a problem today that I gotta work out. I have a deal under contract and it's at title right now. Discounted property. I'm trying to sell it, but there was some foundation issues and now the buyer's not really interested in it anymore. So he's gonna follow up with me today on whether or not if that's good or not. So let's see if I lose my EMD. Alright, so I wake up and I got 9 messages. We're doing pretty good today. Usually it's a lot more than that. But, you know, I noticed it's really easy to make the phone ring, but it's difficult to keep up with all of these messages. I believe that I am always divinely guided. I believe that I will always take the right turn in the road. I believe that God will always make a way where there is no way. I don't believe in defeat. God is always a good God. You can overcome any obstacle. Whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe the mind of man can achieve with PMA. Silence many times is golden. You are the author of your life or the story you truly want. Thoughts create feelings, and feelings create actions, and actions create results, and those results then create new thoughts. Here's a little picture for you. Thoughts, feelings, actions, results. Got that?
Feel centered, feet flat on the ground, back straight, but comfortable, nothing on your lap. And we're going to start by 3 sets of 10 breathing. Close your eyes, hands come up, here we go. Hands flat on your lap, bring it up. Just notice what you feel. 3 moments of our life we can feel grateful for, one at a time. Experience it like it's happening right now. Now, we're going to take 3 minutes and do that little blessing or prayer. Find yourself opening your eyes when you're ready, rising up, and stretching slowly when you're ready. And start to feel the energy of you build up, the energy of all these experiences, the joy, the happiness, the love, the excitement. Bring it into your heart. Feel it. Breathe it. Experience it. Own it. It's in you, as you. This is the real you.
This is good. You see this? I sent him a contract, and he's willing to mostly willing to accept it. That's kind of what it seems like. But he wants to use his title. I want to be a billionaire so fucking bad. Buy all of the things I never had. Oh no, this is bad, this is really bad. I just looked at my email and there was an invoice for my CRM software. I thought I had unlimited texting. Oh fuck. Wait till you see this. Look at that there. SMS usage, monthly, $300, 20,000 texts that I sent. Holy fuck. Yeah, and it gets worse. So that right there is our business capital, but that's the actual amount that I have. Shit's getting low. Okay, you know what? Fuck it. Let's not be upset about this. Let's just fucking make 2 contracts today. 2 contracts today. Okay, that's what we're gonna get. We're gonna get 2 under contract. Okay, you see this? We're sending another contract. Bada bing, bada boom, it's going down. 1 down. You're so bad. But can we touch? I get this feeling. Can we kiss? I'm the fucking back.
Wow, it is beautiful outside today. I try and slip off and go to the park and read in the grass before shit starts going down in the day. I do a little bit before I leave, like, make sure the world is not falling apart without me. But I really just enjoy being able to go to the park and read and just cut all the bullshit out for a little bit. You know, I was thinking, what really is this vlog about? I guess I have to define that. Or do I have to define that? Could it just be about whatever the fuck it is about? Could it just be about my life? What I'm doing day to day? My journey to success? Well, maybe not day to day, because it is a bitch and a half to edit videos. I tried this before and it didn't work out that long. But yeah, you know what? I think it's kind of about my life and my journey. And I really want to be able to look back on these videos and say, that's where I came from and this is where I am. Sometimes I neglect to give myself some good things in life. So I'm gonna get myself a drink from Timmy's and drink it as I'm reading my book. A medium decaf triple made with sweetener, please. Can I also get an extra large cup of ice, please? Yeah, thank you. So, a thing about vlogging is, I don't know if this is with everybody, but it feels a little awkward recording while you're in public. It's kind of like, you know, this is in my own world when I'm vlogging. You know, this is a perspective of Nathan. It's, I feel very, very cut off from the world, and I feel like that makes people uncomfortable when I'm capturing the world. If I had to guess, it's because people are really insecure with themselves and the positions that they are in. And, you know, we often put this filter on everything. And when somebody does a vlog, you know, it's really real and raw. And maybe people just don't want to be real and raw because they don't want to come to terms with the fact that they are where they are because of the things that they did. Nice. Freshly cut grass. Ooh, that's bright. Now this is what I like. Just being able to be in nature and really live it up. So I'm reading this book here, The 10X Rule, and he says in it, and this is really deep, he says, you know, you don't need to grow old to die. Wow, I think so many of us have died on the inside and just given up on life, given up all our control and said, I am at effect to the things that happen around me and not I affect the things that happen around me. Holy crap, wow. Wow. It's just wonderful being able to get away from all the bullshit and read, you know, just getting really down to earth, eh? Quite literally. So sometimes I wonder if I purchased every single house in the neighborhood and then refused to sell them for no more than 10 times what they're worth, how much I can make off of that. I guess I could do the numbers, right? But think about it this way, it's supply and demand, okay? If I gobble up all the supply, and then I demand, there we go, and then I demand that you give me 10 times what I gobbled it up for, fuck, people are gonna pay it.
even just a fine emotion. What the fuck? This isn't even the real one. Does this count as distracted driving? I don't think so, right? Because his hand's free. We'll close this. Getting a hot forehead. Woo! Toasty.
Caught me. You caught me. I did it.
Don't mind best friend.
All these rappers, you know, they don't even like rhyme good shit. They just say stupid shit over and over again. I like this one
automatic door thing. Think about this. In 1950, if somebody said to somebody else, hey, doors are gonna open automatically when you walk up to them, people would be like, what the heck? No way, you're fucking crazy. But now, if you walk up to a door and it doesn't automatically open, for some reason you think there's something wrong. Isn't it weird how the world changes like that?